Hi, my name is John Fay, and today we're going to talk about the redesigned green card and employment authorization documents that were just announced by the Department of Homeland Security on January 30th, 2023. This change will impact anyone who is completing the Form I-9, as both the green card and the EAD are acceptable for identity and employment authorization purposes. In this short video, we're going to briefly review the design changes for these new cards, and then I'm going to provide you with three important things to keep in mind, specifically for your I-9 and E-Verify processes. But let's begin with a question. Why the change? Well, the United States Citizenship and Immigration Services redesigns these cards every 3 to 5 years in an effort to mitigate the risk of fraud and counterfeiting. So, for example, they'll make subtle changes to the artwork, such as the Statue of Liberty seen here on the green card or the bald eagle on the EAD. The new designs will also have tactile printing, secure holographic images on both the front and the back of the card, and then data fields that are actually displayed in different places than the previous versions, which of course becomes relevant for I-9 and E-Verify purposes. And on that note, let's address another question you might have, which is how does this impact the completion of my I-9 and E-Verify cases? The first thing you need to know is the introduction of these new card designs does not mean that the previously issued cards with the future expiration dates are invalid in any way. So in other words, when completing your Form I-9, you will continue to see green cards and EADs with an older design for several years to come. Similarly, this change does not trigger or require any updating of your existing I-9 forms. So for example, an EAD will remain valid until its expiration date or an automatic extension, if applicable. Number two, while it is helpful to know and understand the design changes for these documents, you should always remember that employers do not need to be document experts. So for example, you do not need to get out a blacklight and examine the holographic images on the front and the back. The document review standard that you need to follow is right there on the Form I-9. Does the document reasonably appear to be genuine, and does it relate to the person who is presenting it? That's it. And then lastly, number three, if you're participating in E-Verify, now's a good time to remember that you must keep copies, both front and back, of 4 different types of documents: the green card, the EAD, the US passport, and the US passport card. Each one of these documents will trigger a photo matching step in E-Verify, and as part of the program rules, you actually agree to maintain copies of those documents. One of the best ways to ensure that you are retaining I-9 supporting documents when required is to use a well-designed electronic I-9 and E-Verify solution, and we at Equifax would be happy to chat with you about how our solutions help keep up with these tricky and often changing requirements. And that's all the time we have for today, but please stay tuned for additional updates on both I-9 and E-Verify compliance in 2023 and beyond.